Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on internal combustion engine. And this is lecture number 10. The topic is combustion in CI engine. Combustion in compression ignition engine or diesel engine. So we recap from the previous lectures. Earlier we studied about the fuels and fuel supply system in the CI engine, combustion in the SI engine. So there is fundamental difference between SI engine, CI engine in combustion. So in the case of SI engine, as we discussed earlier, so the air fuel mixer from the carburetor is drawn into the engine cylinder. But in the case of compression ignition engine or diesel engine, the air alone is drawn inside during the suction stroke. So in the suction stroke, the air from the atmosphere through the air filter, the air is drawn into the engine cylinder and it is compressed to a higher pressure. Because only air is drawn inside and it is air is compressed, so the compression ratio of the diesel engine is more, is around 10 to 22. So the air is compressed to a higher pressure. So at the end of the compression stroke, we inject small quantity of fuel through the fuel injector. So there is a separate injection system that also we studied in the fuel supply system. So we have a fuel injection pump and fuel injector. So using the fuel injection pump and fuel injector, a small quantity of fuel is injected into the engine cylinder at the end of the compression stroke. Using the temperature of the compressed air, the diesel starts to burn. So the self-ignition temperature of diesel is low, so it will easily catch fire and burning starts inside the engine cylinder. So this is compression ignition engine. And here we are going to study in this lecture, the topics are in the combustion in the CI engine, we are going to study about the stages of combustion, knocking in the CI engine, and the combustion chamber in the CI engine. So the different stages of combustion in the CI engine, knocking and combustion chamber used in the CI engine. These are all the topic we are going to discuss. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define what is ignition delay in the CI engine. They will explain the stages of combustion in the CI engine. The student will distinguish between the SI engine, CI engine knocking, and discuss the construction and the working of combustion chambers used in the CI engine. So the combustion in the CI engine. So the combustion in CI engine is considered to be taking place in four phases. It is divided into ignition delay period, period of rapid combustion, period of controlled combustion, and period of after burning. So these are all the four stages. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So before we discuss about the stages of combustion, we look into this diagram. So the diagram, in the x-axis we have the crank angle and in the y-axis we have the pressure of the engine cylinder. So the pressure is measured with the help of a pressure sensor installed on the top of the engine cylinder in the cylinder head. The pressure sensor will give the pressure signal, and we measure the crank angle rotation. And with respect to the crank angle, we draw the pressure. And here again, we have the TDC, top dead center. And in the left hand side, 100 degree, right hand side, 100 degree. So, the left hand side, this is called as before top dead center. And right hand side, it is called as after top dead center. So, we start from here. So, the 100 degree before the top dead center. So, this is the compression process. So, the compression, when the piston is moving from the bottom dead center towards the top dead center in the compression stroke. So, this is compression process, and the pressure of the air inside the engine cylinder is increasing. So, it is actually somewhere near here at a 20 degree before the top dead center. So, we are injecting fuel. That is what start of injection. Once the fuel injected, so it will take some time for preparation, and the first phase is called as ignition delay period. So, the ignition is delayed by the first period, and this is called as preparatory phase. So, according to this diagram, so this is approximately 0.001 second. So, the ignition delay period is 0.001 second. And the combustion starts here. So, this is the start of combustion. So, the ignition delay period we define like this. The time period between start of injection and start of combustion is the ignition delay period. And the combustion starts here and there is an increase in pressure. So, once the combustion starts, the gases are produced, the fuel burns and the gases are produced. The gas pressure and temperatures are increasing. So, you find a steep pressure rise. So, it is more than 80 bar. So, the pressure inside the engine cylinder is more than 80 bar. And then the second stage. So, the second stage. So, during this period, the combustion is very rapid. So, that is why it is called as rapid burning or rapid combustion period. Then we have the piston starts to move from the TDC. So, the gases are expanding, but still there is injection. So, injection continues up to TDC. Then 10 degree after TDC. So, this point is TDC. It is after TDC, the fuel injection is continuing. So, third phase is period of controlled combustion. So, once the rapid combustion is completed, so in the period of controlled combustion, whatever the quantity of fuel injected, that is burning. Then we have the fourth phase, period of after burning. So, during the fourth phase, the pressure decreases. So, it is almost expansion process, the pressure decreases. And in the after burning, the amount of burning, amount of heat released during the burning is less comparing with the other two phases. So, the four phases, ignition delay period, 1, 2, period of rapid combustion where you find steep pressure rise, sharp pressure rise, and 3 is the period of controlled combustion where the heat release rate is in the controlled fashion. That means, whatever the amount of fuel injected, that is burning. And the fourth stage, the amount of fuel available for burning is less and the temperature reduces, pressure is also reducing inside the combustion chamber. And we will discuss the four phases in detail. The first phase, ignition delay period, it is very crucial in the case of diesel engine. So, in the case of diesel engine, so the first period, ignition delay period is very crucial. The ignition delay period is also called preparatory phase, which is counted from the start of injection to the start of combustion. So, ignition delay period is the time between the start of injection to the start of combustion. The combustion delay period is very important because it has effect on the combustion rate, knocking, engine starting ability and presence of the smoke in the exhaust. What is combustion rate? The rate of heat release, amount of heat released with respect to the crank angle. And knocking, the unwanted, undesirable phenomena in the engine combustion. And the engine starting ability, how quickly the engine is starting and the presence of the smoke in the exhaust. So, the ignition delay period is divided into two parts. One is physical delay, another one is chemical delay. So, the physical delay, first we take the physical delay. The physical delay is the time between the beginning of injection and the attainment of chemical reaction condition. So, during this period, the fuel is atomized, vaporized and mixed with the air and raised to its self-ignition temperature. So, all these things are happening in the physical delay period. It is only preparatory phase and the fuel is atomized. So, when the fuel particles are atomized, then it is vaporized because the particles are very small. Using the temperature of the compressed air, it is vaporized and mixed with the air. So, once it is vapor, it is in the vapor phase, gaseous phase, and it is easily mixing with the air, mixed with the air and raised to the self-ignition temperature. This physical delay depends on the type of the fuel. When the high viscous fuel, the physical delay will be more. For low viscous fluid, the physical delay will be less. So, the physical delay is greatly reduced by using high injection pressure and high turbulence to facilitate breakup of the jet and improving the evaporation. So, turbulence inside the combustion chamber and high injection pressure will reduce the physical delay. Then the chemical delay period is the chemical reaction till the ignition taking place. Generally, the chemical delay is larger than the physical delay. Once the atomization, vaporization, mixing with the air and raise to the self-ignition temperature, so once the physical delay is over, then Once it is coming to the self-equilibrium temperature, then the chemical reaction is taking place between the air and the fuel. That is what the chemical delay, and this chemical delay is larger than the physical delay. Then period of rapid combustion. The period of rapid combustion is also called as uncontrolled combustion, during which the pressure rise is rapid, because during the ignition delay period, small quantity of fuel is accumulated without burning. So once the starts burning, all the fuel will burn suddenly, and there is rapid pressure rise inside the combustion chamber. That is what the rapid combustion. So the rate of heat release is maximum during this period. And period of controlled combustion. So the rapid combustion period is followed by the third stage, the controlled combustion. The temperature and pressure in the second stage is already quite high. Hence, the fuel droplets injected during the second stage burns faster with reduced ignition delay as soon as they find the necessary oxygen, and they further pressurize in the controlled further pressurize is controlled by the injection train. So what is the amount of fuel injected? So actually, in the ignition delay period, there is no combustion. All the fuel quantities are accumulated, and once the combustion starts, the rapid combustion happens. All the fuel whatever is injected, it is completely immediately burning. So that is why there is a steep pressurize in the rapid combustion phase, and then the fuel particles already burnt. Now the new fuel particle which is coming into the combustion chamber, so with the lesser delay they are burning. That is what called as period of controlled combustion. So the period of controlled combustion is assumed to be end of the maximum cycle temperature, and then the last phase. So the unburnt and the partially burnt fuel particle left in the combustion chamber starts burning as soon as they come into contact with the oxygen. This period is called as afterburning period, and during this period the pressure decreases, the gas is already expanding, and power is produced. So ignition delay period, period of rapid combustion, period of controlled combustion, and period of afterburning. So these are all the four stages of combustion in the compression ignition engine or diesel engine combustion. And actually, when there is a question, you have to draw this diagram. So you practice this diagram, you have to draw the diagram and explain the four phases. The first phase is very important, physical delay and chemical delay you have to explain, and rapid combustion, controlled combustion, and after burning stages you have to explain. Then the first phase, in the first stage of four stages of combustion, the ignition delay period is very important in the case of diesel engine. So the ignition factors affecting ignition delay, actually when the delay period is more, that leads to the knocking tendency in the engine, in the CI engine. So ignition delay period is very crucial in the case of diesel engine combustion. So the ignition delay period is affected by the compression ratio, engine speed, engine output, automation and duration of injection, injection timing, quality of fuel, intake temperature, and the pressure. So we will see one by one. The compression ratio should be increased to decrease the delay period. So when the compression ratio increases, the pressure inside the engine cylinder is increasing. So the automation will be effective, vaporization will be effective, and mixing of the air and fuel will be effective. So all the three will, the physical delay can be reduced. Engine speed, when the engine speed is increased, delay period decreases during the variable speed operation. So when the engine speed increases, the turbulence inside the combustion chamber is increasing. So once the turbulence is increasing, there is effective mixing of air and the fuel, so that the physical delay can be reduced. Output, engine output, with the increase in the engine output, operating temperature increases, and hence delay period decreases. When the engine output is increasing, so because of higher power output, the engine temperature, so the capacity of the cylinder and the compression ratio, the operating temperature, everything is increasing, so which will reduce the delay period. The automation and duration of injection. So higher the fuel injection pressure increases the degree of automation. So injection pressure normally about 200 bar. So when you increase the injection pressure, so the automation rate of degree of automation increases, the fineness of the automation reduces the ignition delay, ignition lag. So the when the fuel particles are fine particles with the fine particle, so the diameter of the fuel particle will be less, so it will easily evaporate and mix with the air inside the combustion chamber. So injection timing, the optimum angle of injection advance generally 20 degree before top dead center. So we have to start 20 degree before the top dead center and inject some 20 degree after the top dead center. Normally in the diesel engine combustion, the crank angle duration for fuel injection is 40 degree, 20 degree on the before TDC and 20 degree after TDC. And the quality of the fuel, self-ignition temperature is important property which affects the delay period. A lower self-ignition temperature result in lower delay period. So other properties which affect the delay period are volatility and viscosity. So lower self-ignition, higher volatility and lower viscosity are required for lowering the delay period. And the intake air temperature and the pressure. So increase the air temperature and pressure will reduce the delay period. And then, so these are all the parameters. So the higher the compression ratio, we require higher the compression ratio, higher the engine speed, higher the output, higher the automation, higher the injection pressure, injection timing 20 degree on either side, and the quality of the fuel, that is, the viscosity should be low, volatility should be higher, and the self-ignition temperature should be low, intake temperature and pressure should be higher for delay, for reducing the ignition lag period or ignition delay period in the diesel engine. Then phenomena of knocking in the CA engine. So the look at the first diagram. So we have the pressure in the Y axis and time in the X axis. We discuss only the delay period. So the start of injection and start of combustion. The start of injection, start of combustion, that is what we called as delay period. And the amount of fuel injected during the delay period. So this is the delay period, and this is the black color strip is the amount of fuel injected during the delay period. And the injection will continue up to this. This is end of injection. So this is a small quantity of fuel injected, and it starts burning here. So once it starts burning, the pressure is increasing, and the pressure will be maximum after the TDC. Then it decreases. So the fuel injected and that is burning. Look at the next diagram. Now the delay period increases. So the delay period is increasing. So the amount of fuel injected is more. Because of the fuel injection is more, look at here. Here the injection starts. So here the combustion starts. Now the pressure rise, it is closer to the TDC. Whereas here the pressure is little away from the TDC. And here it is closer to the TDC. So here the pressure rise, the maximum pressure should be closer to the TDC, just after the TDC, so that we can get more amount of work output from the engine. So in this diagram, we have, comparing with the previous diagram, this is more amount of fuel available during the delay period, and they are burning from here. There is steep pressure rise, and the peak pressure, the maximum pressure, just after the TDC, top dead center, and then it decreases, so that we will get the maximum work output, and the fuel injection continues and it will end here. So the combustion is taking place, pressure is decreasing, power is produced. Now you take this diagram. The delay period further increased. So actually in the first two combustion, so the combustion in the case of diesel, in the case of petrol engine, the combustion starts near the spark plug and the combustion flame is propagating, spreading throughout the combustion chamber. In the case of diesel engine, the combustion starts anywhere. Normally near the exhaust port, because the temperature near the exhaust port is more, so the combustion is initiated near the exhaust port, exhaust area. Flame front is propagating towards the other side of the combustion chamber. Now here in the third diagram, we have little more ignition delay period, and the quantity of fuel injected is very high. And because of that, the combustion starts at different places inside the combustion chamber. All the flames are moving in the combustion chamber, which give the fluctuation in the combustion, which give the fluctuation in the pressure. So this kind of phenomena is called as knocking. So the ignition at a different part of the combustion chamber, and the flame front, number of flames are formed more in the combustion chamber, all the flames are moving in the combustion chamber, that gives a vibrating phenomena, vibration inside the combustion chamber, that causes the pressure fluctuation inside the combustion chamber. That is what called as knocking tendency, knocking in the case of CI engine. So when the delay is very less, the pressure rise, when the delay is very small, the small quantity of fuel is injected and the maximum pressure is shifted far away from the TDC. This is not desirable. And here the delay period is little increased, there is more quantity of fuel and the peak pressure is very closer to the TDC, just after the TDC, and this kind of operation is desirable. And here we have more amount of fuel injected and this causes the knocking inside the engine cylinder. So this is what the knocking in the case of CI engine. Now we compare the knocking in the CI engine and the SI engine. So the first diagram is the knocking in the SI engine and the second diagram is a knocking in the CI engine. So SI engine and CI engine. So what do you observe? So this is the top dead center. Here we have the top dead center. So in the case of CI engine, the knocking occurs near the, actually in the case of CI engine, knocking occurs near the beginning of the combustion. In order to decrease the tendency of knock, it is necessary to start the actual burning as early possible after the injection begins. In other words, it is necessary to decrease the ignition delay, right? And thus decrease the amount of fuel present when the actual burning of the fuel after first few droplets starts. But in the case of SI engine, knocking occurs near the end of the combustion. So here, knocking occurs in the case of SI engine at the end of the combustion. But in the case of CI engine, knocking occurs near the beginning of the combustion. It is due to the increased ignition delay period. So if we want to avoid the knocking, so we have to decrease the ignition delay in the case of combustion, in the diesel engine combustion, so that we can avoid the knocking phenomena inside the combustion chamber during the burning in the diesel engine. So knocking in the SI engine, it is end of the combustion. Knocking in the CI engine at the beginning of the combustion. And now we discuss the combustion chambers used in the CI engine. There are two types of combustion chamber. So the CI engine combustion chamber classified into two types: direct injection chamber. This type of combustion chamber is also called as open combustion chamber. In this type, the entire volume of the combustion chamber is located in the main cylinder and the fuel is injected into the volume. Indirect injection type. So in this type, combustion chamber or combustion space is divided into two parts. One part is called as main cylinder and other part is called as the cylinder head. The fuel is injected usually in that part of the chamber located in the cylinder head. So in a small chamber, the fuel is injected and the burnt gas are pushed to the main cylinder. So the indirect chamber, they are further divided into swirl chamber in which compression swirl is generated, pre-combustion chamber in which compression swirl is induced, air cell chamber in which both compression and combustion swirls are introduced. So we discussed the all types of combustion chamber in the case of diesel engine. So first direct injection chamber, the first type is shallow depth chamber. So look at the diagram, this is the piston. That is the crown portion of the piston, we have the small cavity. So in the shallow depth chamber, the depth of the cavity provided in the piston is quite small. This chamber is usually adopted for large engine running at lower speed. Since the cavity diameter is large, the squeeze is negligible. So the sound created is negligible. And normally we use the multi-hole injector, fuel injector with the multi-hole used for the direct injection chamber. And the hemispherical chamber, so here again look at here, we have a hemispherical shape cavity on the cylinder here, the piston crown portion, and multi-hole nozzle is used for injecting the fuel. So this chamber also gives a small squish. However, the depth to diameter ratio for cylindrical chamber can be varied to give the desired squish to give better performance. And why we provide cavity here in the top of the piston and the piston crown, these are all used for creating turbulence inside the combustion chamber. So we said earlier, turbulence will reduce the ignition delay period. So in the design of combustion chamber, in the design of piston itself, we provide the cavity at the top of the piston to increase or to increase more turbulence inside the combustion chamber. And cylindrical chamber, so the look at this chamber, this cavity, and here the fuel is injected tangentially, so which will give the swirl motion inside the combustion chamber. So this design was attempted in recent diesel engines. This is a modification of the cylindrical chamber in the form of a truncated cone with a base angle of 30 degree. The swirl was produced by masking the valve nearly 80 degree on the circumference. Squeeze can also be varied by varying the depth. And the toroidal chamber, so the idea behind this shape is to provide powerful squeeze along with the air movement, similar to that of familiar smoke ring within the toroidal chamber. So due to the powerful squeeze, the mask needed on the inlet valve is small, and there is better utilization of oxygen. The cone angle of the spray for this chamber is 150 degree to 160 degree. So the cone angle, the injection angle is 150 degree to 160 degree. The turbulence here is more. So the swirl motion or the mixing of air and fuel will be effective in the case of toroidal chamber. So the four types of direct injection chamber. And the main advantage of this type of chamber, minimum heat loss during the compression because of lower surface area to volume ratio, and hence the better efficiency. So the minimum surface area to volume, so that the better the heat loss will be minimum heat loss will be minimum, so that there will be better efficiency. No cold starting problem, fine automation because of multi-hole fuel injection nozzle. And the drawbacks of this chamber are high fuel injection pressure is required, hence complex design of the fuel injection pump. So to produce better automation, multi-hole nozzle, so we require high fuel injection pressure. So the pump design is critical. Necessity of accurate metering of the fuel by the injection system, particularly for the small engine. So these are all the drawbacks of the direct injection chamber. And the indirect injection chamber, the first chamber is swirl chamber, and this is the piston portion, and this is the swirl chamber available in the cylinder head. So the cylinder head, there is a small chamber, axillary chamber. And once the compression starts, a small quantity of fuel is, small quantity of air is rushing to this place, rushing to the swirl chamber. And in the swirl chamber, the fuel is injected using the nozzle, and the combustion starts here. So combustion is initiated in the swirl chamber, the burning starts here. Then when the piston is moving towards the top bottom dead center in the expansion stroke, so the gases here, they are rushing to the main cylinder, and the further combustion is completed. So nearly 40% combustion, 40% air is coming here, and the combustion starts here. 80% combustion only taking place in the main chamber when the piston is moving towards the bottom dead center in the expansion stroke. So this is the swirl chamber, and this is the pre-combustion chamber. So where you have the small pre-chamber, and we have the fuel nozzle here, and here again the main chamber is connected with the pre-chamber through a small orifice. As the piston is moving in the upward direction during the compression stroke, a small quantity of air is going to the pre-chamber. So here the fuel is injected at the end of the compression stroke. Combustion is starting here, the burning is started here, and the hot gases are given to the main cylinder through the small orifice with the higher velocity. So the hot gases flowing with the higher temperature, higher pressure, higher temperature will easily mix up with the air and fuel here, and then it will burn easily. That is the pre-combustion chamber. And then air cell chamber. So this is the top view and the front view of the air cell chamber. The air cell chamber, there are two types. There are two parts. One is the major cell and the minor cell. So this is called as energy cell, and this is the main cylinder, main portion. And the fuel is injected in the main cell. And the small quantity of fuel will rush to the energy cell. So very small quantity is going here, and the combustion is started here in the main chamber. And when the piston is moving downward, so the air from here, from the energy cell, high pressure air, they are rushing back to the main cylinder through the small opening with a higher velocity, which will give better turbulence and better combustion in the main chamber. This is the air cell chamber. And the advantages, injection pressure required is low. And the direction of spraying is not very important. That is the advantage. Injection pressure can be low, and direction of spraying is not very important, and drawbacks are poor cold starting performance because of the two chambers. So the heating in the pre chamber or the swill chamber is less, so the poor cold starting performance requiring better heater plugs, and specific fuel consumption is higher. So the amount of fuel consumed per kilowatt of power is very high in the case of the indirect combustion chamber. So we stop here. So we have some few questions to answer in the reflections part. The first question: name the four stages of combustion in the CI engine. You take a few seconds time, and you answer, write the answer in the paper, piece of paper. The four stages of combustion in the CI engine: number one, ignition delay period; number two, period of rapid combustion; number three, period of controlled combustion; and number four, period of after burning. These are all the four stages of combustion. The physical delay may be reduced by increasing the injection pressure. State whether this is true or false. You pick up the answer. If you have selected the answer true, you are correct. Physical delay can be reduced by injection pressure. Chemical delay is more or less than the physical delay. Chemical delay is more or less than the physical delay. You identify the correct answer. So the physical delay, the answer is more than the physical. The chemical delay is more than the physical delay. Name few combustion chamber used in the CI engine: direct injection chamber, shallow depth chamber, cylindrical chamber, toroidal chamber, indirect injection chamber, swill chamber, pre-combustion chamber, and air cell chamber. So these are all the combustion chamber used in the CI engine or the diesel engine. So we stop here. So these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. You can refer to other internal combustion engine books also for more information. And thank you for watching. So please post your comments on the comment box in the YouTube video. So for improvement, and you subscribe the channel. I have uploaded more than 200 videos on the thermal engineering subjects, and I have uploaded the solution for the gate questions also for your better learning. And you can write to my mail ID or use my WhatsApp number for informing any doubt. I will clarify your doubt. Thank you very much, and we will meet again.